Oggi con The Boat Show vi porto a bordo di una barca un po' particolare. Si chiama RM.
Today with The Boat Show, I am taking you aboard a special boat called RM1070. Designed by the French designer Marc Lombard, an expert in boats that are used to cross the Atlantic Ocean and to race at high speed.
RM in realtà è una filosofia di navigazione.
RM Yachts is actually a sailing and construction philosophy. The hulls are built in plywood covered with fiberglass. The decks are in sandwich.
Come potete vedere, si tratta di una barca piuttosto importante.
As you can see, this is a rather large boat, very large and very powerful. The French like to sail long distances. Above all, they like to cross the Atlantic and go to the Caribbean. And these boats are the offspring of that tradition, what the English call passage maker.
Nel guardare queste barche, allora non bisogna avere l'occhio dedicato ai grandi prodotti di serie da crociera.
When looking at these boats, one must not observe them with the same eye as he would when looking at the great cruising series products dedicated to our Mediterranean weekends. These are the boats with a different mission. That is to have people on board for a long time, to sail in all wind and sea conditions, to be absolutely autonomous. This leads to a different setting when it comes to the layout, the construction and equipment.
La trinchetta e il Genoa sono avvolgibili.
The staysail and the Genoa can be furled. They are always armed, and directly from the cockpit without coming to the bow, you can choose what to open and what to use for sailing. Obviously, as part of the equipment, there is a spectacular Jennaker, this wide and powerful hull which is absolutely suitable for sailing at broad reach, and a Code Zero.
L'armatore ha voluto una barca particolarmente dotata, l'albero è di carbonio, anche il boma, le sarti.
The owner wanted a particularly equipped boat. The mast is made of carbon, so is the boom. The high shrouds reach the side while the low ones are near the deckhouse. There is still a passage for both the people and the Genoa sheep point. There are the running stays to be used when sailing with the staysail to obviously counteract the tension of the forestay.
Da questa posizione si può fare quasi tutto. Questo è il winch per.
From this position you can do almost anything. This is the winch for adjusting the sheets of the headsails. This is dedicated to the halyards. At the stern there are the mainsail sheet adjustments and the furling rail.
Il 1070 ha qualche anno. Quest'anno è stato proposto un rinnovamento degli interni e si chiama 1070.
The 1070 has a few years on its back. This year a renovation of the interior of the model has been proposed, so it takes the name of 1070 Plus. We saw the boat in Cannes. It's a versatile hull. It can be requested with a fixed bulb with a swing keel, which doesn't mean canting, but that it simply bends. The swing keel, as on this boat, reaches a depth of 3 meters. Another option that is ideal for safe grounding is the French-style version with a twin keel with a rudder to be able to lean on the platform, something that, fortunately, in the Mediterranean, we don't need. We have been told that the performance does not change much, even in twin-keeled boats. There's a loss of only a few degrees upwind.
Ed eccoci all'interno di RM1070. Il layout è costruito come tutto.
And here we are inside the RM1070. The layout, as is the whole boat, is thought out for long navigations. This is the typical version of those who want to stay at sea for a long time. A double bed in the bow, a double cabin aft, a bathroom behind this door, a huge kitchen, a large chart table. Behind the bathroom, where there is normally a cabin, there is instead a storage room, where it's also possible to sleep with a makeshift bunk.
Anche dormire con una cuccetta di fortuna. Chi sta tanto in mare gradisce avere un locale per stivare tutto quello che.
Those who spend a lot of time at sea like to have a place to stow everything that charters don't normally have, such as sails, folding bicycles, a small generator, and everything you need when you are out of port for a long period of time and far away from, let's say, civilized places where assistance can be found. Those who sail do it all by themselves on board.
Tutto da solo a bordo.
Obviously, there is also a version with the two aft cabins. But it is not exactly in the nature of this boat that is made precisely to stay at sea for a long time.
In mare per tanto tempo. Tutti gli RM hanno questa zona particolarmente sviluppata.
All RM yachts have this particularly developed area, kitchen and chart table. The floor is quite high, even though I have space above my head and I can see ahead. This means that on long autopilot navigations, anyone who is working inside can see outside.
Qui dentro può vedere fuori. Stiamo finalmente navigando con il 10.70. Vi ripeto, la configurazione di questa barca è deriva basculante.
We are finally sailing with 1070. Let me remind you of the configuration of this boat. Swing daggerboard with two rudder blades. The centering of these boats dedicated to the broad reach navigation usually is never particularly gripping. This helps the helmsman under Jenica and challenging conditions help spring the boat to bear away under gusts. In fact, we can confirm that the two blades help the helmsman a lot. Everything is very light to steer, very sensitive. The boat obeys what the helmsman decides. We're inside the Gulf of Muggia, better known as the Gulf of Trieste, and at this moment we have a full mainsail and a full genoa. Speed is up to 7.5 knots with a wind of around 15 close reach.
Velocità fino a 7 nodi e mezzo con vento attorno ai 15 di bolina larga. RM 1070 mantiene.
RM 1070 keeps what it promises. It is a boat ideal to sail for a long time, safe, suitable for any weather. This was a fun day.